Shalom, I'm Kahan Tazadaq. This is not legal advice. I can't offer you any type of legal advice. Everything I'm about to offer you is for educational and informational purposes only. If you need legal advice, seek yourself a competent counsel, and then please be advised. As of November 2022, America has actually been drowning in credit card debt. In fact, it's at an unusual high. At the end of the cycle, 2022, the credit card debt was around $18 trillion. It hasn't been that high in the past 15 years. So this goes to tell us that many Americans cannot afford to live off of their current salaries, and therefore they're drowning in credit card debt. Now, before I tell you what I did to eliminate credit card debt utterly, I welcome you to come out to my up-and-coming webinar this up-and-coming weekend, December the 31st, the last day of this calendar year, December the 31st, from 12 noon to 6 p.m. on all of your questions in regards to 1099s. We will cover that. I've never done this particular webinar before, so be to sign up now by clicking the link below this video. There will be a webinar on the 1099s, December the 31st, from 12 noon to 6 p.m. Now, get back to the credit card debt. And by the way, the 1099 also teaches you how to handle that credit card debt. Now, here's the thing. This is a YouTube short, so I'm not going to be very long, so pay particular attention. Be certain to share and like this video. To eliminate credit card debt, one must understand that the debt is not yours. It's not Tazadaq's. It's not yours personally. And since you begin doing money transactions, you've actually functioned as a volunteer or voluntarily fiduciary representative for a trust account, just simply by doing money transactions, paying its bills with your energy. Now, when you set up your first checking account, you actually accepted this relationship with the trust account that I'm speaking of. So you established this relationship with the government because they essentially set up a trust account with a name that sounds very similar to yours, and you've actually been taught throughout grammar school, elementary school, that that's your name. In fact, you was taught to answer and respond to the name. So there's a trust account set up in a name that sounds very similar to yours. In fact, it sounds exactly like yours, and you believe that it's your name, but it's really not your name. So you have not had control over this trust because you never claimed it by becoming a secure party creditor, right? Your mother and father didn't know. Now, notice how the money system maintains an illusion, Look at your checkbook, right? Look at your checkbook. Oh, we didn't have checkbooks, right? How did they actually present the name that you believe that's yours? It's in all capital letters, right? Isn't that odd? Isn't that against everything that you actually learn in the English language and grammar school? Well, of course it is. So try to have them change it to the normal up and lowercase letters. They can't do it. So you gotta ask themselves, go into to any bank and say, can you change my name on the checking account to up and lowercase letters? They can't do it. Why? Because their computers won't permit it. The computer is designed that way. The bank staff may not even be aware as to why they can't do it, right? So do they insist on all caps because they would like it to be very clear and allow no mistakes? Is that why? No. See, a clue to that answer is that the line on which you sign your name, it's not a line. It's merely microscopic words. It's words in microscopic print, like only authorized representative. That's what's there. If you get a magnifying glass and look at that check, it says authorized representative. So you, they made you that human being, have actually been given the authority to sign the check of that trust account, which is actually, it's literally an incorporated entity. It is a fiction. The checking account is not yours. Therefore, do you know the debt? Do you owe the debt? No, you really don't. Because it's not yours. You don't know who you are, so you've actually established joinder and you became a liability because you signed your name there without awareness, without full disclosure, and you believe that that's you. So if you learn who you are, you become a secure party creditor, you take yourself out from under all of that debt. Click the link below the video and become a secure party creditor now and be certain to tune in to the up and coming 1099 webinar this weekend by clicking the link in the room. I'm Tazadaq, and this has actually been Tazadoctrine, a YouTube short. Shalom.